Are you one of the students who are stuck in writing research proposals because you still do not have the research titles? Or you already have the research titles, but you are not sure if these are correct or not? If you are one of the aspiring researchers and you want to know the essentials in writing good research titles, then this video is for you. Welcome back to this channel. I'm Teacher Sam, your online learning buddy. Pasok ka na naman, and I know some of you are enrolled in Research 1, which is the development of research proposal. In this video, I will discuss the essentials in writing research titles. I will also share with you some do's and don'ts in writing research titles. And please watch this video till the end because I will provide some examples in some disciplines which might be a good reference in your next research study. But the first thing that we have to do is let us define what is a title and why it's very important to have a good title.
The title is a brief descriptive label which summarizes the main idea or ideas of your study. The title is without doubt the part of a paper that is read the most, and it is usually read first. When other researchers will look for references or related studies, they will browse the net and key in the title. If you have a good, clear, and catchy title, more readers will be interested to read your work. The more your work will be read, the possibility of having this paper to be cited is high. So what are the ways to come up with a research title? First, choose a research topic. What is a research topic? A research topic is a subject or issue that a researcher is interested in when conducting a research. A well-defined research topic is the starting point of every successful research project. Selecting a topic is the most important part of the research process. Students may encounter two problems: too many ideas or no idea at all. On one hand, some students might have lots of ideas. They might be interested in online gaming, students' attitudes, study habits, academic performance, teaching strategies, COVID effects, health issues, etc. So the first thing that you have to do is to choose one from these broader topics: language, education, arts, business, health, politics, sports, math, science, etc., which interest you. In my case, I am interested with language. So what I will do is to think of subtopics under this broad topic in which I am knowledgeable at and interested with. Importante na knowledgeable ako sa topic na ito kasi kung hindi, hanggang sa title lang ang kaya kong ma-achieve at hindi ko matatapos ang pagsusulat. Kapag naman interested ako sa topic na ito, once nag-start na akong magsulat, I am determined to finish my work kasi interesado akong malaman ang mga bagay na ito. Since language ang pinili ko, ang mga subtopics under this broader topic are phonology, semantics, morphology, syntax, and pragmatics. Afterwards, I will read articles and existing studies about these subtopics. Eventually, after my research, I may come across with these very specific topics. For instance, in phonology, I may encounter terms like pronunciation, phonemic awareness, stress, intonation, and speech disorders. For semantics, word meaning, sentence meaning, idiomatic expression, figurative language, and inference. And for morphology, word formation, prefixes, suffixes, lexemes, and morphemes. For syntax, sentence structure, subject-verb agreement, clauses and phrases, word order, and models. For pragmatics, nonverbal communication, speech acts, implicature, cooperative principle, and presupposition. Reading articles and studies about these subtopics will provide me the salient details and the needed information about the topic I wanted to study. Let's say through my reading about phonology, I got information about phonemic awareness, which is important for reading and spelling. Through further reading about phonemic awareness, I obtained significant information from an article that a child who struggles with one of these interrelated skills, such as phonemic awareness, is likely to have a poor reading ability. So based from my initial research, these are the keywords that I had: phonemic awareness, child, and reading abilities. So if I will develop my research title, it could be this way: phonemic awareness in relation to reading abilities of elementary pupils in urban schools. Or it could be like this, phonemic awareness and reading abilities of elementary pupils in urban schools, their relationship. Kapag naman education ang broader topic that I am knowledgeable at interested with, ang mga possible subtopics nito ay ang mga sumusunod. Teaching strategies, learning styles, instructional materials, leadership styles, and students' performance. Let's say through my reading about students' performance, I got information about students' performance in algebra. Through further reading about how to improve the students' performance in algebra, I obtained a significant information about Bagatrix, which is an artificial intelligence application in teaching normal distribution. So based from my initial research, these are the keywords that I had: students' performance, Bagatrix, and normal distribution. So if I will develop my research title, it could be this way: Bagatrix, effects on students' performance in normal distribution, or pwede din ganito, effects of Bagatrix on students' performance in normal distribution. As a recap, choose a title as to your interest and discipline. The choice of a good title for the study poses a demanding but challenging search for an area of investigation that is closely related to your professional goals, expertise, experience, and interest. Another way to have a research topic is to look around you. Observe and identify the problems, be it at home, in school, in the workplace, in the locality, in the community, in the classroom, in the office, etc. Now, halimbawa sa classroom niyo, you observe that there are some students who attended the class late, submitted the output late, failed in the exam, got low scores in the quizzes, etc. These are just some of the problems that need to be taken care of. From these problems, you already have the key terms: students' tardiness, low performance, procrastination, etc. When you research for these terms, you will obtain significant information that will guide you in the formulation of your research title. These are the possible titles that you could have: tardiness, absenteeism, and academic achievement of junior high school students in English courses. Or factors contributing to the absenteeism of junior high school students in rural schools. Now, what if you have observed that students are just throwing their trashes everywhere, and you could see them that there are no proper waste disposal in school? That is a problem, right? You may come up with research title like this: Waste Management Awareness and Practices in a Government-Funded Institution. Another way is to read published research articles online, especially published articles from refereed journals, or go to the library and read some theses and dissertations. Then look for the blank spot and the blind spot. Ano ba itong blank spot and blind spot in research? Thompson in 2012 differentiated these two terms. Blank spots are the things that are not yet covered by this study. Kung merong mga topic na hindi pa na-cover o nagawa ng research study, ang tawag dito ay blank spot. Lahat ng studies ay merong specific scope, location, time, context, specific people, and thing. However, meron bang other circumstances in which the existing research doesn't cover itong mga bagay na hindi pa nila na-explore or na-studyhan ay tinatawag na blank spots. Ang blind spots naman, these are the things such as the method, definitions, or theoretical approach which do not allow to be seen or said. Sa madaling salita, research gap. For example, may research study na na-conduct using a survey. That survey answers the questions such as how many and how often. However, it does not prove the reasons why this may be the case or that might be the case. So perhaps you may conduct a case study that may allow you to build really rich descriptions about it, or conduct the study using qualitative approach by utilizing thematic analysis from the in-depth interview conducted. Or, if a research article revealed that socioeconomic status is a factor for students' absenteeism, while other research article revealed that it is not a factor, based on this, it is clear that both research have different findings, so there is a research gap. So conducting a study on this topic will fill in the gap. All research has blank and blind spots, and we just need to know what they are so that we know what we are legitimately able to say. 4. Replicate existing studies. Look into some printed journals in your school. They can be found in the libraries or perhaps borrow from your teacher. These journals and book of abstracts contains scholarly works written by research enthusiasts in the country and abroad. Perhaps after reading some of the titles, you will have an interest to explore further on these topics. These studies might not yet conducted in your school, so even though the titles may be almost the same, but if the research environment, respondents, and instruments are different, these may yield to different results. Number 5. Don't hesitate to ask guidance from your instructor, advisor, or someone you know who is engaged in research and has been publishing articles in refereed journals. Before I know the do's and don'ts, I'm also guilty about the mistakes I committed in writing research titles. Good thing I have some friends who are very good in research, and even until now, I still seek further comments and suggestions. As the famous saying has it, more heads are better than one. Pag meron ka ng nabuong title, marami ka pang dapat isalang-alang at dapat tandaan kung paano magkaroon ng good research title. And these will be discussed in my next video.
So good luck everyone, and I hope you learned something from this video. If you are new in this channel, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell for you to be notified in my next uploads. See you in my next video. Happy e-learning!